Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello everyone and welcome to Teddy Reviews. I'm Teddy Cuddlesworth. We have a very special episode today. I really could not put this one down. The story moved me. The characters gripped me. But let me add this. The story also discusses very polarizing topics, so taking another person's opinion about the game wouldn't do it any justice. So I encourage everyone to go out and experience this game and form your own opinion. One of the main controversies in the game was this new character, Abby. To be honest, I was not thrilled to be her at first. They set it up in a way in which you could not be frustrated. I was like, why the f*** am I Abby? When I should have been asking myself, why am I Abby? I should have been more Seinfeld and less Rage Against the Machine. But once that light bulb hit me and I realized why I'm actually this person, it sent chills through my body. It has such a powerful message. We won't get into spoilers right now. Let's get the obvious pleasantries out of the way. The basic pillars of a game. Graphics, gameplay, fighting mechanics, sound design. We're gonna cover all those, and then we'll get to the spoilers at the end. And it will be marked, don't worry. So let's kick it off with graphics.
You know what I love about you? How you let me finish my sentences.
Everything is photorealistic. It's like they actually built these sets and scanned them into the game. From the character models, to the worlds, but most importantly...
You wanna fuck them up?
To the facial expressions.
Yeah, I do.
You asked for it! Better run, you little shit!
Yeah, this'll work.
This game gets its immersion through the emotional involvement in the scenes. Not really through the actual gameplay like most games attempt to do these days, which I feel is a welcoming addition to video games. You feel like you're actually inside these characters' lives and dealing with the emotions they're attempting to cope with. There's a lot of story that's told through facial expressions and body movement, especially with the side characters. Subtle Mona Lisa grins you have to look out for that really accented the storytelling. But as far as graphics go, there really is no complaint. This game is top-notch, best out of the best this generation. Next on the agenda is gameplay.
Oh my god.
Dog really upped the ante when it comes to the chase scenes, something I personally have been craving, and they delivered. There's several sprinkled throughout the game, and they never get old. The vastness of the landscapes, coupled with your ability to parkour, just takes it to the next level. They also added a prone mechanic to further deepen the gameplay, which makes for a plethora of tense scenes. The self-bandage mechanic seemed a bit half-baked. If they were to flesh it out more, it really would have added to the lack of immersion in the gameplay. Another minor discrepancy would be the safe combinations. They chose a very cumbersome input method, and searching around for codes is pointless. Everybody just does this anyways.
Got it!
Once I figured out the beauty and the accessibility options, it literally took out every frustration I had with the game. I wanted to focus on the story, not whether I needed to go right or left, chasing my tail for 20 minutes while I figured it out. One last thing I'd like to touch on would be the puzzles. They definitely took a couple cues from the Uncharted series and greatly improved on this mechanic. Up next, we have fighting. Abby's a badass. I went for more of a stealthy approach with Ellie. This hold-up mechanic from Metal Gear Solid is a definite highlight, and I would try to do this at least once every encounter. We got dogs. We have definite dogs. They're kind of fun. Not annoying at all. A handful of new monsters. Like the first game, there isn't very many boss fights. They go for mostly a cinematic approach. Maybe a bunch of bosses. Might have messed with the pacing. Who knows? It's up to the devs.
Yes.
There's not a lot of variations in weapons, but what you get does work, and weapons feel good to fire. Your ship with Ellie doesn't have a life bar like the first game. So shiv away. One last odd occurrence would be that you can't move dead bodies after a stealth kill. Hopefully nobody sees that. Next up, we have sound design. Is Teddy's take. I'm not crying, you're crying, okay? Dude, that montage was amazing. Amazing.
No, it wasn't.
I'm a grown-ass teddy bear, and this video game made me cry. Is that what you want to hear, you monster? I can understand that some people could say there was pacing issues, which is why I kind of enjoyed playing it on an easier setting, because I really just wanted the story. The gameplay was cool. I mean, it was serviceable. It was good stealth mechanics, which there aren't a lot of these days. I really wish there was multiplayer, especially with the hold-up mechanic. It would have been really fun to implement that in PvP. Or if they added co-op survival in that big town you start off in, defending against hordes at night and gathering for supplies during the day. But there's other games you can do that in. There's no other games where you can get a crazy cinematic emotional adventure. I will replay this game in the same fashion I will rewatch a TV series I like. So this part is going to have spoilers. Let's get to my ending reaction. So if you don't want to hear spoilers, go ahead and watch our last review of Final Fantasy VII Remake. Got a couple chuckles on that one. Go ahead and check us out. Give us a like on that too. Support the teddy bear news. So about the whole Joel dying scenario, which some people are really upset about. Did you get upset when Heisenberg died in Breaking Bad? I mean, you know Joel's no Heisenberg, but Joel probably killed more people than Heisenberg. That's for sure. Well, maybe not if you count all the math.
Math is math!
which, anyways, not the point. Irrelevant. I mean, also, it's not like Joel dying really meant anything. Within the next hour of the game, you are Joel again in a flashback, and that happens repeatedly through the game. There's a lot of story of Joel's life that we can still play. It really does not affect you at a gameplay level, because you're still going to be able to play as him in the past. So the obvious lesson in the game would be that revenge is bad, which ultimately is synonymous with empathy. So the game is a beautiful tale about empathy, in which the world could not get enough of right now, in my humble Teddy opinion. And I feel like anyone that is frustrated with that aspect of the game maybe might need that lesson that they're trying to give you. Calm down a little bit. Absorb. Don't control. Absorb and digest and let it out. That's the Teddy way. As far as the ending goes, it was lame.
You're lame.
It just ended. Ellie just walks off, no fingers, no Dinah, no baby.
Ellie,
super sad
Dinah.
Face. Though the ending seemed anticlimactic, if Ellie actually ended up killing Abby, after seeing the horrors Abby had to go through, those guys that kidnapped her at the end did Abby way worse than Ellie ever would have been capable of. That was horrific what Abby went through. And if you still are mad that Ellie did not kill her after that, then you are a terrible person. I'm sorry. I love you though. I still love you. But HBO show on the horizon. That's gotta be tight. If my favorite parts of the game were the cinematic aspects, I'm gonna love the HBO show. So hurry up and make that, because I have to wait till the end of PS5 for The Last of Us 3. So take me away, HBO. Oh, also, if you're still here, like and subscribe.